महाराजा कृष्ण कुमार सिंह जी भावनगर यूनिवर्सिटी लाइब्रेरी वॉज एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन द ईयर 1979। सेंट्रल लाइब्रेरी प्रोवाइड्स सर्विसेज एज एन इंफॉर्मेशन सेंटर टू द लेक्चरर्स एंड स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ 24 पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट्स डिपार्टमेंट्स ऑफ कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट कॉलेजेस। रिसर्चर्स एंड एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव स्टाफ ऑफ भावनगर यूनिवर्सिटी कैन ऑल्सो अवेल ऑफ दिस सर्विसेज।
Hi Kavishalatya.
Hi Simarato.
I'm going to take you all on a virtual to visit to our central library.
So today, we, the leaders of Library Committee operating at Department of English, take an opportunity, owing to COVID-19, to provide a digital visit or a virtual visit to Central Library.
Jim Rohn quotes, "Reading is essential for those who seek to rise above the ordinary." The Central Library of Bhavnagar University provides a peaceful reading room facility to all the readers who seek to gain knowledge. The timing of this library is from morning 11 a.m. to evening 5 p.m. The services provided by Central Library includes article index of selected periodicals, weekly display of new arrivals, reference files of selected topics, individual attention, and helps the user to locate their required reading materials. Display of prospectus for various courses of national as well as international universities. And it also displays the newsletters.
Central Library contains reference books on all the subjects and courses offered by the university. There is a special collection of bound volumes and important scripts, periodicals, medical gazette, etc. This collection includes Journal of Scientific and Industrial Research, Banking and Finance, the Insurance Times, Finance India, Science and Culture, Chartered Secretary, Journal of Entrepreneurship, International Journal of Information Technology, Vikalp, the Journal for Decision Makers, International Journal for Mobile Computing Devices.
Magazines like Digit, Educational Technology, Indian Labor Journal, various types of bibliographies, Grishobha, Abhiyan and Jagruti, Yojana, India Today, students can sit in the reading hall and read all these books. Some special books have been purchased by this library, which can be useful to students in the preparation for competitive exams. Postgraduate students, PhD researchers, PG teachers and professors can become members of this library.
As Walter Savage Lander says, that nothing is more important than exploring a library.
So let's try to open up the windows to the world that inspire us to explore and achieve
and contribute to improving our quality of life, as Sidney Sheldon believes.
And what's the key to open up these windows to the world?
Yes, I have found a very valuable key in my wallet, and that is our library card.
There are various stack rooms at our central library. The stack B on the first floor is the English book section. Literature students can explore books on world literatures, criticism, fiction, art, biographies, and literary history of the world.
Students attend sessions in classes. But do you think it is enough for mastering a subject?
Of course not. Student must read further to enhance the knowledge of the relevant subject.
Libraries provide more additional study materials, and that helps students to gather more information about their subjects.
And it helps to develop a variety of perspectives on the topic.
There are so many books in this library, and sometimes it becomes difficult to find the exact book which we are looking for. The stakes cover Indian writing in English, Shakespearean literature, African literature, Canadian literature, Indian poetics, American literature, new literature, modernist literature, postmodern readings, and many more interesting books on various theories. This library is RFID enabled. There is an OPEX system available which is very helpful to find a book within a few seconds.
આપણી ભાવનગર કૃષ્ણકુમારસિંહજી મહારાજા કૃષ્ણકુમારસિંહજી ભાવનગર યુનિવર્સિટીમાં
સેન્ટ્રલ લાઇબ્રેરીમાં ઓપેકની સિસ્ટમ છે જેના વિશે આપને મિલન સર ત્રિવેદી જણાવશે.
વેલકમ. ઓપેકનું ફૂલ ફોર્મ છે ઓનલાઈન પબ્લિક એક્સેસ કેટલોગ. આપણી લાઇબ્રેરીની અંદર જેટલી બુક્સ અવેલેબલ છે એ કયા સ્ટેકમાં એના લોકેશનમાં કઈ જગ્યાએ છે એ જાણવા માટે ઓપેકનો યુઝ થાય છે. પ્લસ કોઈ ટાઇટલ હોય, તમને ખ્યાલ હોય કે આ બુકનું આ ટાઇટલ છે, ઓર ઓથરવાઇઝ પબ્લિશર વાઇઝ, એ બધા રીતે તમે બુક સર્ચ કરી શકશો. સૌ પ્રથમ તમે જ્યારે અહીંયા આવશો ત્યારે આ સ્ક્રીન ઓપન હશે કમ્પ્યુટરની અંદર. તમારે અહીંયાથી સર્ચ બટન ઉપર ક્લિક કરવાનું છે. સર્ચ બટન ઉપર ક્લિક કરશો એટલે આ રીતની આખી વિન્ડો ઓપન થશે, બરાબર. આ છે બેઝિક સર્ચ. બેઝિક સર્ચની અંદર તમે આટલા ફિલ્ડથી બુક સર્ચ કરી શકશો, જેની અંદર ટાઇટલ, ટાઇટલ પ્લસ સબ્જેક્ટ, ઓથરવાઇઝ, એક્સેસન નંબરવાઇઝ, બરાબર છે, ક્લાસ નંબરવાઇઝ, ISBN નંબર, પબ્લિશર વાઇઝ, અલગ અલગ ફિલ્ડથી તમે સર્ચ કરી શકશો. સપોઝ ટાઇટલ વાઇઝ આપણે સર્ચ કરવું છે તો બુકના ટાઇટલનો કોઈ એક કે બે કીવર્ડ અહીંયા ટાઈપ કરવાના છે અને અહીંયા સર્ચ ઉપર બટન દબાવશો. સર્ચ બટન એટલે માની લો આ જે કીવર્ડ આપણે ટાઈપ કર્યો છે એ ઉપર જેટલા પણ બુક અવેલેબલ હશે ટાઇટલ એ અહીંયા શો કરશે, બરાબર છે. સે ફોર એન એક્ઝામ્પલ, મેં અત્યારે ફ્રીડમ સર્ચ કર્યું હતું તો ફ્રીડમ નામના જે ટાઇટલ હોય બુકના એ બધા અહીંયા ડિસ્પ્લે થશે, બરાબર છે. અહીંયા ઉપર બતાવશે 1 to 10 રેકોર્ડ્સ ફાઉન્ડ આઉટ ઓફ 20. ઇટ મીન્સ 20 બુક છે ફ્રીડમના ટાઇટલ ઉપરથી, બરાબર. એમાંથી 1 થી 10 નંબર અહીંયા શો કરે છે, બરાબર. પછી નેક્સ્ટ જશો એટલે 11 to 12 20 તમને શો કરશે. હવે સપોઝ કન્ટ્રીબ્યુશન ઓફ રાઇટર્સ ટુ ઇન્ડિયન ફ્રીડમ મૂવમેન્ટ એ બુક તમારે જોઈએ છે તો એના ઉપર તમે ક્લિક કરશો આ રીતે, બરાબર છે. એટલે અહીંયા એની બધી જ ડિટેલ બતાવશે. એમાં અહીંયા નીચે સબ્જેક્ટ્સ, કોલ નંબર અને એક્સેસન નંબર, પ્લસ એક્સેસન નંબરની સાથે અહીંયા અવેલેબલ છે કે નહીં એ પણ બતાવશે. સપોઝ કોઈ સ્ટુડન્ટ આ નંબરની બુક લઈ ગયું છે તો અહીંયા ઇશ્યુડ બતાવશે, બરાબર. અને જે આ 809 છે એ તમે સ્ટેક રૂમમાં જશો એ 809ના કબ્બડમાં તમને મળશે. આ રીતે છે આખું ઓપે, એ તમને બુક સર્ચ કરવા માટે યુઝફુલ છે.
The book dropping machine allows student to submit the issued book easily. The library provides an instruction manual for the kiosk for self-check-in and check-out of the books. Members will get laminated identity cards as a proof of their membership. Books are very expensive, but they can be issued for a limited time from the library to students to develop their understanding and enhance their skills set on the required subjects. To borrow a book, just touch borrow on the touch screen and then scan your identity card. Instructions will be displayed on the screen. You can put multiple books on the desk in front of the machine, but please make sure to check out all of them to be displayed on the screen. Don't forget to take the receipt when you finish the transaction.
To return a book, touch Return on the touch screen. Place your book in the machine along with library card and follow the instructions displayed on the screen. You can also check your account, renew books and pay any outstanding library fines. Follow the on-screen instructions or ask staff at the help desk for advice.
Make sure you never fail to explore this library.
Yes, after this visit of Central Library, we would like to take you all to our department's library.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Welcome to Department of English, MK Bhavnagar University. which offers PG and research courses in English language and literature. Its aim is to create conditions for education that enhance the students' academic as well as personal development. Students are exposed to various digital tools which help in learning literature effectively with the help of technology.
Students can get all the course-related materials, study books, reference books from the mini library of English department. It includes books on modern linguistics, philosophy, elements of literature, Oxford and Cambridge dictionaries, encyclopedias, and various books on authors. Students can expose themselves with these books in their free time.
Visiting a mini library of our department can also
enhance our trust for developing reading habits and gaining knowledge.
A library is an important source of knowledge for the young minds. It develops the important habit of reading among the students. Students can contact library committee leaders for issuing the books. They can refer to the list attached on the stack or can directly ask the title of the book. The committee is keeping a record in a master of the books issued and submitted by the students with particular date. Each book carries a code number on its hardcover. The students borrowing a book can check the details and sign in the master. Students are also advised to explore their understanding of the read book by writing a book review blog. In the department's language learning lab, students feel free to occupy themselves with reading books on books or discussing their views on the books they have read. A peaceful reading environment is provided to all the students. They can refer to the original text while appearing in the open book online test, or they can read PDFs or ebooks while writing thinking activities. Now, let's know about our audio-visual library. There are more than 150 CDs and VCRs available.
Apart from classroom discussions, we also prefer to enhance our understanding in a deep-depth manner with the help of audio-visual mediums for the better clarity of our subjects.
Yes. This audiovisual medium includes CDs as well as DVDs of famous adapted plays or short stories as well as novels.
In our department mini library, we also have VCDs for scope examinations, which help or which gives us an opportunity to attain proficiency in English language. J.K. Rowling says that when in doubt, go to the library. I'm sure we can get all the answers from books, and books also help us in questioning our life.
Yes. J.R. Bowen says that I have always imagined a paradise like a library. So here is our mini paradise.
These are the books donated by late Professor Dr. Upendra Shah from MS University.
And we are very thankful for his act of kindness. Thanks a lot.
Incomplete without taking the insights of the head of English department, Professor Dr. Dilip Bharat sir. So sir, we request you to share some insights on
what is the role of library in the lives of students.
Okay, library is a holy space in any academic journey, like the way we have Makkah, Medina, Kashi, or a soul in the body. The same way, library is the soul of any academic institute, and No academic institute is complete without library. No student's life is complete without a role of library in their life. Library is a place which is a source, which is the fountainhead of all the knowledges that students are supposed to get from.
Thank you, sir. Now, in the time of digital libraries, what major difference can we see between e-book and the hard copies? And what significance does it play in the life of students?
Yeah, very interesting, yeah. So nowadays, like our soul has become more virtual now. Our holy space has become more virtual. And so virtual libraries, we carry libraries in our pockets now. But still, the kind of a feeling that a physical book perhaps may give, it is still very difficult to get the same kind of feeling from e-books. Maybe I say this because I have grown into a time where there are more of physical books. Now the new generations grow into a time where there are lots of digital books available, and their access to digital books is more than the physical book. So they may have a different way of looking at either e-book or a book. But I would like to show this, that I still love to have lot many books. I have here lot many books in my laptop also. But then if there is a choice, whether this book, perhaps helps me a lot in very quick reference to something or quickly finding the things, then the physical books are something that is very, very helpful there. But then again, I say that maybe we have grown in 80s when there was nothing like digital libraries or e-books. So perhaps our minds are hardwired to go more towards the physical books than e-books. The new generation people perhaps may be hardwired in a different way to look towards e-book also. So we should always remain open towards either book in form of print or in form of digital. Book itself is very important thing.
Aesthetically, if we look at this physical copies of the book, we may find that great readers have sensed the very smell of the book.
Yes.
That is very hard to find in the newer generation.
In the newer versions also, yeah.
And sir, nowadays the concept of anti-library is very famous. So can you please throw some light on that?
Umberto Eco's concept.
Yeah,
yes.
That's a very interesting one. Umberto Eco, Italian thinker who gave this concept of anti-library. Umberto Eco was again a kind of a scholar who remains surrounded by lot many books. And even if whatever they write or say, it always keeps on reflecting their reading also. So people when visit this kind of people, they are impressed by the kinds of books that they are surrounded by. So he used to say that there are two kinds of people. One who come to your space and see, oh, so many books. How many books have you read from this? That is what they say. The second group of the people, they say, they understand that books are not supposed to be read thoroughly. They are research tool. They are supposed to be referred only. They are not. So they never ask, have you read all these books? That is altogether a different group of people who ask, have you read the books or not? He would say that no, books are not only for reading completely, they are research tools. So he gave this idea, anti-library. It means that you get surrounded by the books which you have not read, but you want to read. You keep on purchasing books, not necessarily for reading. So people may have a question, what is the purpose of that? The purpose that he says is that when we are surrounded by books, our ego is not inflated. It is humbled, and it always keeps on reminding that there is so many things still I don't know. So all these books keeps on reminding every day that there is lot many things still that we don't know. So we never get an inflated ego that I know everything, that we never come. That is how anti-library is very important. There is a Japanese word which is like a sundoku. Sundoku is starts with T, like tsunami. Sundoku is the word. It also means the same thing, that buying a book and leaving it without reading. So compiling books, you keep on purchasing, don't read, that is also that concept. But very interestingly, this concept of Umberto Eco is also taken by another scholar, Nassim Taleb. Nassim Nicholas Taleb has taken this concept in his book, The Black Swan. In Black Swan. And he referred to the very idea in a very interesting way, like those are true scholars who constantly keep on telling about what they don't know rather than what they know. So that is Black Swan idea. So he said that, do we have anti-resume? We have resume, CV, biodata, where we say what we know. Well, people should also think that you have a resume where you say, I don't know all these things. I want to know, but I don't know all these things. That is again very much enriching to the people. So from library to anti-library, library is a place where we go when we are hungry to know, when we realize that, well, I don't know, then only we understand the importance of library. The same is the idea about anti-library, that the more books we have, it keeps on reminding us that there are a lot many things to be yet known in this world also.
And we are becoming a lifelong learner.
Lifelong learners, yeah.
So thank you, sir, for this productive end of our video.
Yeah, I wish you all the best for this video that you are making for library, as a part of a library committee, and I have yet not seen the entire video, but I hope it will be a very interesting video. I wish you all the best.
Thank you, sir.